Peace. Peace to my divine infinite consciousness and peace to my divine infinite self in all realms and realities. Yo, our nature absorbing the negative ions, you know, fully stimulating the full chakra system inside and out. But yeah, we're going to have to jump up into it, yo. This is about niggas who lie for bitches and semen retention, all right? Now, niggas who lie for bitches, that's pathetic, yo. Seeing in the eyes of the Most High. Man, it's like, yo, when the man is the truth and he got to lie for a bitch, I'm talking about, I got to say it like that because, you know, say if the dude, you know, his girl got with another dude or whatnot, and the other dude, you know, pretty much was like, you know, banging the girl, you know what I mean? She doing some nasty ass shit to him or whatever in the fuck, and, you know, basically, her main dude finds out or whatever, and it's like, yo, shit, what the fuck, what's going on, you know what I mean? And the other dude like, oh no, we ain't doing nothing, we just friends, you know what I'm saying? Some pathetic ass shit. Why lie for the bitch for? First of all, she like, damn, you ain't shit because you fucking with me and I got a dude and you lying for me. Oh yeah, so the type of relationship that they have, they already understand, so they cool with each other. Really, they not really in love, but it's actually cool. And the main reason why niggas get mad in the first place, because a woman is so submissive. She's real submissive. When you have a self equality or sex with her, man, she's like giving herself to you. You know what I'm saying? You're basically tilling the soil and planting your seed, giving her these emotions, you know? So when you see her do this to other beings and then or other men, you know what I'm saying? Or just happen to find out that this mug is nastier than you thought, may do threesomes or gang bangs on the low that you ain't even know nothing about during her little single times, you know what I'm saying, while making the man believe that she's this fucking virgin or some shit, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, you can understand why you're a little hurt a little bit, because you got a little heart of gold, you know. And but when you run into the dude who's actually lying, that can look you right in your face and lie for her, it's like, damn, nigga, damn, you, I can't really trust you. Who the fuck is it? Oh damn, that's fucked up. So therefore, that becomes the split between brotherly love, even if y'all don't even know each other like that. It's like honorable, like, yeah man, I bang her, she came to me, da 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 da, or I didn't even know her, da da da, or I came at her and she just let me, what you call it. See, as a man, you know, you really can't even be mad at the another man and shit. Now if you got it on lock, you really can't even be mad at your wisdom and shit, you know what I'm saying? It may not even be your wisdom. If she go out and share that self-equality and think that there's nothing to it, then you have to stand firm on your square and don't deal with her ever again. Now, if you choose to deal with her again and it's on self-equality, now you're seeing that this is really what it was about anyways, the understanding of this. So now you can be having a side mug or whatever, and then y'all both got something. It is so much mixed energies, you know what I mean? And so much insecurity that's involved with all those energies. So when a man lies for this chick and she's known for her own self, she haven't faced herself yet that she be fucking motherfuckers and shit, you know what I'm saying? And she haven't faced the science of knowing how to and understanding how to purify herself, then you fall victim and to her karma. So it's like, if you don't have or practice semen retention and build your light up, you will fall into the quicksand like the rest of them. And when a wisdom is giving herself away like that, it's like, in the eyes of a virtuous woman, that is a very weak woman, you know what I mean? Because she's succumbed to the weakness of herself, which is dealing with sex. As a man, he really doesn't even think about sex often. If you go without it for a while, you'll forget about it and you'll start thinking about creating shit. Because why? This is what man do. And when she sees that you create, she jumps into her creative temple and starts to create also. But when you went out onto the lower self as a man and start releasing often, especially with your own wisdom, because she's going to do what it do, and she sees this, but she can feel the light diminishing as you do, and you're not planting seeds, then she's going to only reflect you in this world. So it means it's going to add on to her naturalness of just wanting to mate for genetic purposes and strengthen the gene. Now she don't have the judgment to see who to mate with. Now it's just about the feeling. If a person could just fuck without no period, they would at this day and age. So now they're giving head a lot more. They realize the science. So when you're lying for a person that does this naturally now and they haven't looked at themselves, and it's not saying to hate these mugs, but shit, when you say things to them, I mean, the way they look, it makes it appear that their emotions is soft and gentle. Ooh. And in reality, them motherfuckers is, them emotions is hard, rough, sharp, sharper than yours. You look, and this is her emotions is like how you look on the outside, hard, rough, and rugged. But on the inside, you are nice. You're lovey-dovey. You're loyal. You're compassionate. When you're low self, you're just a attention seeker. You know what I'm saying? You're lost. And you're dealing with self-equality to get gratification as a man and also as a woman. You know what I mean? So, and on the inside, she's, and on the outside, she's soft. You know what I mean? And smooth. Smells good, stuff like that, you know that. So that's just how that works. That's how nature works. So figure out the nature of each other. So when a woman or a wisdom try to replace you real quick, like to let you see that she get another dick quick, in our natural state, that is funny. I mean, in our real supernatural state, that is a laughing matter. This is an earthly plane. That just shows that this being is still stuck here, and it's going to be here while you're elevating. And so to make you think that, oh, since I was yours, now I can give myself to someone else, you know what I'm saying? This is a dagger to try to hurt you. So if your semen retention ain't up, yeah, it can probably get through. But if your shit's up and you quick to heal, then that shit'll bounce off, boom, and hit her back, like, and shatter on her. So it's just how that works, man. You know what I mean? So basically, the alpha male, the beta male thing, you know what I'm saying? The way that it's going about on the internet right now is just like, you know, hey, this is like a narcissistic game for men who is just trying to get pussy and shit. And it's like, for what? Pussy? Come on, man. You know, and it's like, and then I can understand if it was your stable, like you're trying to get these as your stable. But these are like everybody's stable. Like when you break up with a wisdom, she's going to go fuck another nigga or another whoever, nigga. Just something. She's doing that. She's missing something. You know what I mean? And so you can wonder, like, damn, how could she get over? Nigga, this is her in her, this is her gene, motherfucker. You have to go all the way up in the higher self and realize what was your weakness, why did you do this shit in the first place, instead of the third, and healing your heart at the same goddamn time. So it's important for you to be in your square. But this whole little alpha male, beta male, whatever the fuck, the beta male is the one who's trying to take care of these little broads, these broads. While she's chasing after the alpha male that don't even really want her. Now, we ain't going to be the narcissistic side of it. And there's a whole many other kind of males that we could put into it just to be all intricate. Well, we know the main one, yo. So that whole little shit is, that is to play against you. Especially with dealing with when they call the size matters and all these different things, it doesn't. If you're like cursed or something, then it's different. But I'm just saying, I haven't seen a wisdom with a power of you that really was like a very short one. Like, never seen that one. You know what I'm saying? I've seen some wisdoms with some short ones, you know, short vaginal, whatever, you know what I'm saying? But not like how you see a man that has a really shrivel. So that might be a different thing. But you know, at the same time, you're dealing with self-equality, that's going to deal with, you know, gayness or whatever when you drop to your lower self, when people learning about their lower self in the spirituality, where, you know, when men start having self-equality or sex with other men, you know what I'm saying? Because it's obvious that this man, he can't really penetrate something else. So he most likely will get penetrated to have an orgasm of some sort. And that's dealing in the time of the world where people are like, you know, when it's like a fallen age, you know what I'm saying? It's a fallen age, and those type of beings are produced then. But that's a whole nother story. But right now, protecting this one being that's gonna go out and do what they do, and you just like, it's just like, yeah, just I don't even see what the reason to do it for. So you can get some more pussy or something from her. I mean, And then you can be cool with her forever, I guess. And she'll just give you the pussy or head or whatever forever to whoever get attached. I don't know. But I guess it's a part about the lie. You want to hurt the other individual too. Like, you know, that you, and you got over with something. That's dealing with that cluster B personality disorder. You know what I'm saying? So that just proves a weakness right there. You know, everyone has to replace each other or idolize each other and devalue each other and then discard each other like they never even gave a fuck by using the ego. You know what I'm saying? But meanwhile, it's the scar that you try to look past by putting other entities in this place or other beings in this place to try to cover up those wounds. You know what I'm saying? It's like a sloppy little gash up under there, you know? So it's like, damn, you know? The best thing to do is to focus on self. Eat right. You know what I'm saying? Get your right rest. You know, eat mainly fruits and melons and berries and stuff. You know what I'm saying? And also, you know, eat clear food. You know, this is about spirituality, spiritual discipline. You know, it's not about fucking a bitch. I mean, I know how I fuck, man, shit, I fucked bitches before. You know, wisdom, whoever you want to call them and shit. You know what I mean? They ain't my wives right now, so they mother, yeah. And I ain't even mad at them and shit. They didn't just got my heart, you know what I'm saying? I agreed to probably build with some. And then just show you the brokenness of individuals, you know what I'm saying? When people think that they got you, that's when they start doing the idolize, the value, and discard mechanism and shit, you know what I'm saying? Where they start trying to look for other supply or seeing that if they got you, they'll look for other people to have on the side to come to occupy their attention or to get their energy. It's basically like that. So it's like, you know what? You're dealing in the world with these beings. Starve these motherfuckers, man. Because you cool really as your own self. I don't see no niggas going to go to a place to congregate to watch bitches do something unless it's the strip club. Niggas ain't going nowhere to see no bras doing nothing. So I'm just letting you know, man. Niggas will go watch each other do something before they go watch a broad, man. You got to get back to that mind state, man. And you can't get to that mind state if you're watching porn and fucking jacking off all the goddamn time. Now, I can see if you're studying porn, that's different. But if you're watching it all the goddamn time, come on, man, just for pleasure and dopamine, nigga, you lowering yourself. You ain't gonna never, they gonna master you every time. A woman that's just regular on the street can do something regular to you, and you just like, oh, you look at her and objectize her and shit. You know what I'm saying? Because she already doing that to you. She can look at you. You know it naturally. She can look at you and go up and down and go, that's the bold ones. You know what I'm saying? Man eaters, nigga. Like, shit, they done figured it out. So, yeah, man. In this day and age, celibacy, you know, and getting yourself right and exact. Self-examination, self-understanding, self-mastery, you know, the true self, the light, the energy, that. Force, the magnetism. Other than protecting some broad, if you don't get the pussy no more, you just don't get the pussy no more. If you don't hit it that one way that you wanted to hit it one more time, you just ain't gonna do it one more time. It's gonna be somebody else's time. But you ain't gotta lie to the brother, especially if you open in his intent in that way. So, yeah, man. Don't touch another man's wife. Let her ass go out. If she come to you, yeah, I guess you have the choice then. But you ain't gotta go to her. Shit. Alright, so with that being said, I'll say peace. Make sure you subscribe to all the other channels. We got the athleticisms, we got the psychology, we got just the natural, God by supernatural healing rant. You know what I'm saying? We got just whatever we want to talk about, you know? So basically, the food, you know, everything you do, the tarot reading, all of it. So make sure you go ahead and tune in. I'm gonna have to put some links up because it's gonna be hard to find. But sooner or later, you know what I'm saying, you'll catch on and be like, oh, okay, this motherfucker all over the place. All right? That's what I'm saying. I don't need 100,000 subscribers. I just need the right ones to catch on, right? So with that being said, I'm gonna say peace, more love, and I'll be with you later. Peace.